Hello YouTube world, it's Akeisha from Life Exchange Coaching, Life Exchange Ministry. So I have a challenge for you guys. I don't know who wants to, but I'm challenging you guys, especially the ladies, you guys to take up a challenge with me this year 2020 to walk into your purpose, to align your life into your purpose, to do what you were called, created, do what's deep down inside of your guts that you want to do. So that's our challenge this year. I'm challenging myself, as my gut feeling is ministry, my gut feeling is, you know, testifying about how God has delivered me or taken me from zero to becoming an hero. Yes. And so I want to challenge you guys to find your gift of whatever it is, of singing, your gift of being an investor, finding your gift, an actress, lawyer, a doctor, a real estate broker, anything that your gut is telling you that you want to do. That is your purpose. And I challenge you today that you will go to my website. I have a lot of things there if you want to find your purpose and if you want to walk into your purpose and how to plan, how to go about doing all of those. I have it there. I have lots of materials on my website for you to just start it, to find who you are and just challenge yourself throughout this year. Because knowing your purpose will allow you to become prosperous. I was talking to someone and, you know, I was talking how throughout my lifetime, being at like the different jobs that I have worked at, no one ever thought that I was poor, I was in need, I am less off. People think highly of me because I never give them the doubt, even when there's fear, like I'm fear. The other thing is, like when I'm at work, I do not allow these people, my management, to think that I am in need of their job. No, they are in need of me. You need me. I don't need you. And that's how I kind of live my life throughout growing up. And now I started to look back on it because something came up with one of my friends and we were talking. And then I realized that I aligned my life differently and aligning my life into my purpose, not knowing willfully that was what I was doing. And I thought, like, I remember telling someone I'm rich and they're like, what, you are? And I'm like, yeah, I'm rich. Father is rich. But I never explained myself to them. But I know deep down inside I was talking about God the Father. That's my father who is rich. And I think this person just have it in them that thinking, yeah, Akeisha is wealthy, she has money, she's better off. And there's a certain way that I normally carry myself. So there might be some people that's watching my video that have worked with me, but I am a person that bring myself in a certain way, very classy. Certain clothes you'll never catch me in, certain brands you'll never, and as you know, I shop at the thrift store and I'll buy my brands at the thrift store. I either drive a Benz or a BMW, not to boast, but either a Benz you will find me in or a BMW. So those are the two cars that's in my garage. And I guess people look at me thinking that, okay, she has a nice car, she dresses really nice, she have a home, like she's a homeowner, so she's probably in a wealth area. And then whenever I get like laid off from work, I find that these company, the management, does not feel sorry for me. They're more like, you know what, she's in a better place than other people, so you know, it's okay, she can afford. But deep down inside, I cannot. I struggle like anyone else, but I never bring that out of my mouth. I never let that come out of my mouth that I'm struggling. No, my father is rich. I can do all things through Christ who has strengthened me. And those are the words that I speak out of my mouth, speak to people about myself. You'll never hear me say that, oh my gosh, I'm so stupid. Yeah, I do said that to myself, but not around people. And never you call me an idiot. Never you call me stupid if you want to see me get hangry. And it was something that was a part of me growing up. And until now that I started studying the Bible more and listening to motivational videos and listening to people that are wealthy or people that we look up to, it made me realize that I was heading into the right direction. I was actually aligning my life into a prosperous direction. And every time I lost my job, every time I find that my life has been elevating one step at a time, and I sit back and I'm like, God, I never stopped to think and realize this is what's going on. So I want to challenge you guys, and I'm in it too, because I want to conquer this 2021. I want, at the end of this year, there's a lot of happy people. There's a lot of women that start their own business and not dependent on like a paycheck to paycheck to pay their bills. We are here to conquer this world, to walk into the life that God prepared us for. You know, He gave us everything that we need. He gives hands, feet, mouth, eyes, like all our senses. If you think about it, all of those wealthy people that we want to become like or to be like or we are jealous of, they have the same senses that God gave us. And He gave us 24 hours in a day. But how do we use our senses, especially our mind? You know, how do we use it differently from those wealthy people? And how do we use that 24 hours that was given to us different from those wealthy people? So that's my challenge for this year, 2021. I have a lot of resources again in at my website, www.lifeexchange.com, and some of them is for free. Some stuff you may cost you just $1.99, nothing over $5. And if we can use some of these guides to guide us through 2021, I guarantee you that we will walk up prosperous. Go ahead, subscribe to my channel, and let's do this challenge together. Hope you guys have a great day, a great week, and a great month. See you in my next video.